Hey everyone, it's Chris from Platform9. Today I'm going to take you through Private Cloud Director and some of the new capabilities that are available as of our February release. Platform9 Private Cloud Director is a great alternative to VMware and VMware platforms like VMware Cloud Foundations, VMware Foundations, and VMware Enterprise Plus, providing a complete private cloud platform with infrastructure as a service, Kubernetes as a service, load balancing, DNS, and more. Traditionally, people have worked with Platform9 and we've been a SaaS-based private cloud provider. Now, users are able to install Private Cloud Director on-premise and replace vCenter components directly, or traditionally work with Platform9 as a SaaS platform, as we always have done. What you see on the screen right now is the login to Private Cloud Director. This is not normally somewhere that there's a lot of exciting elements happening, but with Private Cloud Director, you'll see immediately here that we have a domain that we need to choose from. Every Platform9 user gets its own instance, and that instance can then be divided up into multiple domains. Think of that as maybe Coke and Pepsi running side by side, but completely unaware, or your production environment next to your developer environment, all running on shared infrastructure. I'm going to hit login, and I'm going to log into our default domain and take you through a little bit about Platform9 Private Cloud Director. What we're able to see on the screen here immediately is a dashboard showing the health of our virtual machines, the health of our hypervisors, and importantly, my tenant quota usage. Once you log into a domain, you're then able to, as an administrator, slice that domain up into multiple tenants. In this case, I'm logged into the service tenant. There's also an engineering tenant that I could choose to switch to if I wanted to. Tenants can have administrators and self-service users. Importantly, you'll see here alongside of that, is the ability to change between regions. If you have multiple data centers, you can have multiple regions. It will keep all of the settings and configurations, and importantly, the underlying physical resources completely separate as true region should be for a cloud. Lastly, over here on the left is our main navigation. And the top menu here, we're actually able to switch between working with virtual machines and working with Kubernetes clusters. Right now, we're in the view of virtual machines. And I can see here that we're getting pretty close to some of our compute quotas. So if I was a self-service user and I needed to do a bunch of work, I might be reaching out to an administrator saying, hey, I'm getting close to my quota utilization, what can I do? To be honest, they're probably gonna say, hey, you need to delete some of your virtual machines, just like they would say to on the cloud when you start spending too much. So how do I work with VMs? I come over here to virtual machines and I can immediately see VMs that are running, my quota usage, VMs that have already deployed. And to deploy a new VM, it's very simple. Just hit deploy new VM. You can choose how you want this VM to be created. I'm going to say boot this from a new volume using the backend, maybe NetApp or Pure Storage or HP, Dell EMC storage that you've got attached. You choose your operating system, and then you choose the size of the VM you want to deploy. Choose the network you want it to run on. Give it a name. Choose your SSH key, or in this case, give it none. If we're using server groups for keeping servers consolidated onto a host, doing affinity or anti-affinity, choose that, and then click deploy new virtual machine. It is as simple as that. The VM is now getting created. That's off in the background. While that's happening, what I actually want to do is change to Kubernetes, which is a big part of the February release of Private Cloud Director. This is one single platform that's providing infrastructure as a service and Kubernetes as a service. One platform. What you're seeing here right now is an overview of four different clusters that are running within this Private Cloud Director instance. I can see that two are healthy, two are scaling up, and there's no upgrades in progress. Good information to know. Over here on the left, I'm actually able to switch between different Kubernetes clusters that are running in my environment. So I'm going to click test new and I'm going to click manage. Immediately I can see that everything is healthy. Control plane, node groups, worker nodes. I can see my CPU and memory usage and I can see that I could do an upgrade. What is unique and interesting about Private Cloud Director and how we're delivering Kubernetes is you never have to run the control plane. That's all delivered and managed by Platform9. All you ever have to do is work with your node groups and worker nodes. So now I've drilled into the cluster. I can see I have one node group and I've got three worker nodes. Just like EKS, AKS, and GKE, there's no master nodes to look after. There's no Kubernetes control plane. That's all running as a set of services within Private Cloud Director. So immediately saving you money on your infrastructure and really simplifying a lot of that Kubernetes operations as well. Really truly delivering like a private cloud or a public cloud as a private cloud. The next piece to pay attention to here with Kubernetes is that these worker nodes are automatically lifecycled when you make the cluster. Private Cloud Director is talking to your physical infrastructure, those hypervisors where those VMs are getting created, and it's automatically deploying those VMs as part of the Kubernetes cluster. Same goes for upgrades and auto-scaling and auto-healing. If a node is unresponsive, it'll get replaced. If we're doing an upgrade, it'll just deploy new nodes with the new versions of Kubernetes and operating system patches deployed. To demonstrate that, I can either come here and click, I want to add a new node group. I choose the size of that VM, and you'll notice this is very similar to what we just saw when we were working with the VMs. And then I can turn on auto scaling, I can set the maximum number of nodes, and set the network I want this to run on, and click add new node group. If I'd done that then, we would have seen a new node group appear, and new worker nodes starting to spin up, right? I can also come in and edit an existing node group. For example, if I come here, click edit, I can say auto scaling 5, desired nodes 4, I can configure the scaling strategy, hit save changes, and immediately we're going to actually see a change in the size and the number of VMs running for that node pool. So here you see, node state is unknown, machine status is provisioning. If I click on this, this virtual machine will actually be provisioned into that infrastructure environment that I was just in, and we'll be able to manage that from within our VM environment, just like one of the existing ones here. So here I am, I'm back on our virtualized clusters view. I see I'm drilled into a VM instance. I can see the tasks, the networks, any storage attached to it, you know, the relevant information I need to manage that infrastructure and that virtual machine. Lastly, I'm just gonna click back here to virtual machines. I wanted to touch on some different elements that are here. I can see here, I've got a VM, I might want to manage that. I can choose to power cycle, life cycle, all those capabilities, but I have other actions, things like resizing and live migrate. If I need to adapt the size of my VM, that can be done. That could be the CPU, the memory, the storage. If I'm, for some reason, wanting to move that VM, live migration will just move it straight across to another hypervisor that's available. All of this and more are available for use in Private Cloud Director. It's a single platform. It's available as SaaS-managed or self-hosted, where you install it in your data center. If you'd like to know more, reach out to Platform9 at platform9.com. Thanks for your time.